In the Father and the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Today is the last Sunday of the blessed months of Misra, and next Sunday will be the month they call it Al-Mansi, and that will be the end of the new the Coptic year. So, as if next Sunday will be the last Sunday of the Coptic year, and the tradition of the church actually trying to teach us, you know what, to everything under heaven will have an end. So that's why they come to the end of the year this week. You listen to the Gospel of Mark chapter 13. Next week we'll listen to the same Gospel but from the book of Matthew chapter 24. And both of them talks about one thing, the end of life. And as if the church is trying to remind all of us, you know, the end of the year, it's basically all of us who have to think of there will be an end of life for everyone. None of us here will live forever. حتى في الكسل يكون يقول لك إيه ما هي حياتك منها بخار يظهر قليلا قليلا ثم إيه يطمحل. That's it. It's everything has an end. And that's why even Solomon wrote, he said, to everything under heaven, there's a time to be born and a time to die, a time to love, a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. To everything, there's a time. For the church trying to tell us, you know what? It's the end of the new Coptic year, which basically the end of life here on earth. And what happened, our Lord, it's a beautiful, actually, chapter Mark 13, in Matthew 24, give a beautiful description about the end of life. What exactly will happen? And the story, actually, our Lord God served Christ inside the altar. And while he was walking outside of the altar, some of the disciples told him, you know, you see how it's a beautiful altar? It's amazing how it's built. For Jesus, our Lord God served Christ prophesied and said, by the way, this altar will be destroyed. Will be actually teared down completely. And this has actually happened in the year of 1970, during the time of Titus the king. Four of the disciples, when they discovered Jesus know everything, they asked him a tough question that all of us actually will long to know that about it. What will be the end of life? And this is a dilemma of all of us here on earth. Imagine kada, somebody will give us a beautiful description. Here is what exactly is going to happen at the end of life. All of us, that day, will be ready. That's why the Bible today, watch and pray. And they ask you, tell us, when the second coming? When this life here will end? Our Lord God served Jesus Christ, actually, in Matthew 13, and also in Mark 13 and Matthew 24, give a beautiful description in three ways. Number one, he said, what will happen to the earth here on earth? What will happen here to life here? He said, you know, a nation will rise against nation, a kingdom against kingdom, which will be famine and earthquake, will be also hurricane, as we saw last week. You know, imagine kida, if somebody was trapped in Houston and kida hanging, has no phone and the water is about 6 feet, he think this is the end of life. That's it. I remember even during 9/11, you know, many people thought that's it. It's the end of life, because when you are trapped in one of the floors and you have no connection to anybody, and you feel like everything is like destroying, you feel this is the end of life. For number one, our Lord God said, give description about the end of life. Number two, also he give what will happen to the believers. When he said, you will be betrayed in my name, you will be hated in my name's sake, a father will betray his son, a son will betray his brothers, and he explained exactly what will happen to the believer, and how there will be also a false Christ would rise. And the last actually description he gave also what will happen when the second coming, when our Lord God service Christ arise. He said the sun will give dark, will get darkened, the moon will not give its rays, and basically the stars will start falling. And he explained exactly what will happen to this, when exactly the second coming happen. But four things I wanted to leave in your mind about this, because I'm sure the biggest dilemma that all of us will struggle with, when will be the end of life? When will be the end of life? It's a dilemma for most all generation. Matter of fact, I was reading an article that so many books are sold because so many people calculate how the end of life. Everybody interesting, what will happen to the end of life. But our Lord God said, Christ gave four things here. He said, number one, be patient. Don't worry about what will happen to the end of life. Be patient. Even if you hear about all this kind of what will happen, but be patient. Then he said, whoever endure forever will save his soul. For number one, he's asking us to learn how to be patient. Number two actually said, heaven and earth will pass away. But my words will by no means pass away, which means a confirmation that, you know what our Lord God Savior Jesus Christ is telling us is true. Don't ever doubt. Don't ever allow people to tell you, look, here is what will happen. And you start having some doubt in your heart and your mind. Because faith is the substance of things hoped for. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. And also the evidence of things not seen. That's what faith is. We read the Bible, we understand the Word of God, we trust the Word of God. For number one, he said, you know what, be patient. Number two, have a confirmation that, you know what, heaven and earth will pass away, but what I'm telling you right now, what will happen, will never pass away, which means have faith in Christ. Number three, actually, he said, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. All of us, we can sit here, because the end of life, the fact is, the end of life could be my last day today on earth. That's it. So I'm not worried about when Christ will come. So therefore, don't worry about it. That's why he said today in verse 32, he said, that day and hour, no one knows. No one knows. For therefore, do not worry about it. Which means focus on your salvation. Focus on your relationship with God. Don't worry about what will happen. Even in the book of Revelation, chapter 22, he said, behold, I'm coming quickly. When? Nobody knows. For therefore, number one, it's a confirmation. Number one, be patient. Number two, confirmation that heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will not pass away. Number three, which basically do not worry about it. Don't worry about it, but focus on your relationship with God. Number four, which is the most important point I want to talk about, he said, watch and pray. He said, take heed, watch and pray. Which a message to all of us, watch and pray means be ready. Establish, watch means a struggle. And let me explain to you exactly. Take heed means listen and pray and pay attention. When somebody take heed, you know, it's like somebody telling, can you pay attention to me? I'm talking to you right now. For number one, take heed means pay attention. Do not be distracted by anything. Pay attention to the word of God. Watch means observe, to look and keep looking. Watch means to observe and keep looking. Be watchful. Be watchful. Yani at night, the watchman basically taking, or the guard that basically guarding like a bank. You go to any time you find the guard standing with basically, is not going to sleep, is standing and make sure that he's watchful, make sure what will happen. For number one, he's telling us, take heed. Number two, watch means a struggle, means be gahed, means do not worry. Number three, I said, they pray. For the message to us, very simple. Don't worry about the end of life. Don't worry about when will be the end of life, because it could be any day for us. But number one, be patient. Number two, have faith in the word of God. Do not doubt the word of God. Number three, don't worry about the day or the hour. And the most important thing, watch and pray. Watch and pray. أحبائي النهاردة أحبائي الإنجيل زي ما بتكلم النهاردة عشان الأسبوع الرابع من شهر مصر بيتكلم عن نهاية والأسبوع الجاي آخر أسبوع في السنة القبطية فالكنيسة بتركز كل على أن نهاية العالم والنهاردة السيد المسيح شرح في مرقس 13 كيف لما السيد المسيح كان في الهيكل وهو طلع من الهيكل كده قال للتلاميذ أن على فكرة الهيكل ده لا يترك حجر على حجر وفعلا هذه النبوة تمت سنة 70 في عهد تيتس الملك وبعد كده التلاميذ قالوا له واضح ان انت عارف كل حاجة قول لنا امتى نهاية العالم طبعا كلنا نحب نعرف امتى نهاية العالم فالسيد المسيح عاد يشرح لهم ايه اللي هيحصل للعالم نفسه أمة على أمة وزلازل وباء وبعد كده ايه اللي هيحصل للمؤمنين نفسهم وزي لحظة ان هو المجيء الثاني او لحظة رب المجد لما يجي ازاي الشمس تظلم والنجوم تسقط ولهم هذه اللحظة ولكن هو عطى أربع حاجات مهمين جدا عطى أربع حاجات قال لهم على فكرة اوعى تهتموا بنهاية العالم أول شيء خليكم عندكم صبر أول ما تسمع عن حروب ولا بنسمع اللي حصل لإخواتنا في هيوستن وفي تكساس خليكم patient لأن ساعات sometimes الواحد مننا ممكن يكون في situation يحس ان هي دي نهاية العالم زي ما كنت بقول كده في 9/11 الواحد حس ان فعلا دي نهاية العالم خلاص كده وأمشور إخواتنا اللي هم تأثروا في تكساس سبيشل في هيوستن وفي البلاد دي كانت أيام صعبة وعزكوا على فكرة كلنا نصلي ليهم وبنفكر إن إحنا كمان ككنيسة زي نساعد لازم إن إحنا how to help our brother and sister in Texas وإيفن نساعدهم بصلاتنا وsome financial support also to help them يعني. لأن أي حد بيكون عنده hardship بتكون صعبة جدا. فبعد كده قال لهم number one خلي عندكم صبر. الصبر. وقال كده الذي يصبر المنتهى هذا إيه؟ يخلص. يعني أهم شيء إحنا كلنا على فكرة عندنا مشكلة. مشكلة الصبر. كلنا أنا بعاني منها ومشير كلنا بنعاني إيه؟ ما عندنا الصبر. وفي البيوت ما بقى فيه الصبر. وفي حياتنا ما فيه الصبر. وكلنا كده. فبيقول لا ما تقولش أهم شيء ولكن number one تكون عندك إيه الصبر. Number two عطى تأكيد. تأكيد قال لهم إيه؟ السماء والأرض يزولان ولكن كلامي إيه لا يزول. يعني أنا الكلام اللي بقول لكم عليه ده سوف يحدث. لا تشك في كلمة ربنا. خلي عندك إيمان. نمبر ثلاثة قال لهم هذه الساعة ما حدش يعرفها إلا غير إيه؟ رب المجد نفسه. فقال لهم إيه don't worry about it. ما تقولش هم لحظة مجيء إن إيه ما تنشغلش بيها. ما تخليش وقتك كله مشغول إن أنت بتفكر إمتى هيجي. لا بدل ما في الوقت ده فكر انك تكون علاقة مع ربنا وتصلي مع ربنا. اخر شيء احباء قال لهم عبارة قوية جدا اسهروا وصلوا. وكلمة اسهروا على فكرة يعني ايه؟ يعني فيها جهاد. عايز اقول لهم على فكرة خلي بالكم كلمة سهر يعني عايز اقول لهم جهدوا. وصلى اللي هي نعمة عطية من عند ربنا. فالواحد في حياتنا مع ربنا محتاج حاجتين. محتاج يجاهد ومحتاج مين؟ نعمة ربنا. بدون نعمة ربنا مش ممكن اجاهد. وبجهادي ممكن ان انا برضو ايه جهادي بدون نعمة ربنا مش قادر اجاهد. فلازم اجاهد. والجهاد ونعمة ربنا بيعملوا مع بعض. ما يقدروش الاتنين ينفصلوا عن بعض. زي بالظبط كده اديكم مثال جميل في العهد القديم. موسى النبي بعد ما خرج من مصر ودخل بعد كده لقى حرب قوية جدا اسمها حرب العماليق. عماليق جبابرة. فموسى حارب بعت يشوع يحارب العماليق وهو واقف. فتقول القصة ان كل ما موسى رفع ايده يصلي ويشوع بيحارب يشوع ينتصر. موسى ينزل ايده تبص تلاقي يشوع بيخسر. فدي بتورينا عمل الجهاد اللي هو يشوع بيجاهد وموسى بيسام بيمثل عمل النعمة ونعمة موسى ونعمة الصلاة بتشتغل. في حياتنا احنا كلنا محتاجين ان احنا نجاهد. اسأل نفسك كده هل فعلا بتجاهد في حياتك الروحية؟ الجهاد معناه السهر. الجهاد معناه ان انا ايه اكون watchful. الجهاد في آية كده في الإنجيل يقول لك في تيموثاوس 2:5 بيقول إيه إن كان أحد لا يجاهد لا يكلل إن لم يجاهد قانونيا. فهل جهادك هو قانوني؟ واحد الآباء القديسين بيقول لك لا يكلل إلا الذي يجاهد ولا يجاهد إلا الذي يحارب. يعني عشان يجاهد عشان يكلل لازم أجاهد. طب وعشان يجاهد لازم إيه؟ لازم أحارب يعني. فالنهاردة رسالة بسيطة جدا اسهروا وصلوا. قل لنفسك كده ربي هل فعلا عندي حياة روحية؟ هل بجاهد؟ هل بصر؟ هل بقضي؟ ويمكن كلمة تصهروا معناها ان ايه؟ اجهد نفسك. الحياة الروحية مع ربنا مش تكون سهلة. عايز كده اتغصب. وهو بيقول كده ملكوت السماوات تغصب والغاصبون ايه؟ يختطفون. ربنا يبارك فيكم ويدينا دايما ان احنا لا نعول هم هذه اللحظة. وزي ما بيقول لنا النهاردة اول شيء يكون عندنا الصبر. بصبركم تقتلون انفسكم. السماء والارض تزول ولكن كلمة ربنا لا تزول. تأكيد ان فعلا كلام ربنا لينا ثابت. نمبر 3 لا ما تشغلش بالسعادية ولا تبقى فكرك شغال. ولكن اهم حاجة نمبر 4 ايه؟ اسهروا ايه؟ وصلوا. اسأل نفسك كده في وقت القداس كده خدوا رحلة. قول للقداس النهاردة يكون رحلة ايه؟ سهر وصلاة. علمني يا رب كيف اجاهد في حياتي الروحية. ربنا يبارك فيكم ولنا كل المجد والكرامة الى الابد امين.